Escitalopram is one of the most frequently prescribed antidepressants. However, many patients do not respond to the escitalopram treatment. While certain patients are not able to respond to escitalopram under any circumstances, in some cases the treatment failure is caused by the insufficient drug exposure. The FDA-approved drug label for escitalopram recommends a daily dose of 10 mg and defines the maximum daily dose of 20 mg. However, the dose increase from 10 to 20 mg of escitalopram per day significantly increases the risk of side effects. Consequently, being able to predict the escitalopram exposure for an individual patient would help in making the decision whether or not to increase the dose. 2C19 isoform of cytochrome P450 enzyme is responsible for the metabolism of escitalopram. CYP2C19 gene is polymorphic, and common variant alleles are causing either a loss or gain of function of the enzyme. By changing enzymatic capacity, the CYP2C19 genotype affects the escitalopram metabolism. In this study, we analyzed the data derived from 2,087 patients treated with escitalopram, with the aim to quantify the impact of CYP2C19 genotype on the escitalopram drug exposure and treatment successfulness. The patients homozygously carrying inactive CYP2C19 allele do not possess active enzyme, and they are usually referred to as poor metabolizers. These patients exhibit threefold increased escitalopram serum levels and threefold increased incidence of treatment failure compared with the carriers of normal CYP2C19 genotype. Because of the high expected drug exposure, the dose increase is very unlikely to improve the treatment response. It can cause dose-dependent side effects, and it should therefore not be considered in these patients. On the other hand, the patients carrying CYP2C19*17 gain-of-function allele metabolize escitalopram quicker, and they are usually referred to as ultra-rapid metabolizers. These patients exhibit a decrease in escitalopram serum levels, increased incidence of being exposed to suboptimal drug levels, and increased incidence of treatment failure compared with the carriers of normal CYP2C19 genotype. Because of the substantial risk of being exposed to insufficient escitalopram levels, dose increase has a potential to improve the treatment outcome, and it should be considered in these patients. In the elderly patients, metabolism slows down, leading to the approximately 60% increase in escitalopram serum levels as measured in this study. Therefore, the dose increase should not be considered in the elderly, regardless of the CYP2C19 genotype. This is in concordance with the current recommendations from the FDA-approved drug label for escitalopram. In summary, the results obtained from this study demonstrate that CYP2C19 genotype has a major impact on escitalopram exposure and clinical treatment outcome, and support the utility of preemptive CYP2C19 genotyping for the personalization of escitalopram therapy in clinical practice.